Welcome to the SCP Foundation Integrated File Server. To begin, please insert your Foundation personnel badge into the card reader. Authorization. Approved. Please select item's numerical code to view. Processing. Your file is ready to view.
All that I am warning, this file has alerted informational temporal disruption textual analysis. ITTA. Programs embedded in the network to the presence of a potentially anomalous file origin. Underscore code. AC3, memetic hazard, type V underscore this file was archived and flagged as potentially hazardous on July 22, 2017. If you do not recognize this file, do not proceed without the inclusion of one or more approved textual analysis scripts. Underscore. 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 Retrieving. Underscore. 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 Loading original page content. Underscore. 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 File analyzed. Show hazard filters. Y. N. Underscore. 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 Your answer. N accepted. Displaying text. Underscore. 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 If you're in these pages looking for facts and logic, I can give you a little of both. Remarkably, I can tell you that there was no first SCP. Because I wasn't there for it to happen. The first anomaly, of course, was long before us, and the document format came long after we figured out what we are doing anyway. The more I ponder it, the more I realize that perhaps it was also several decades before there was even a we to begin with. This organization wasn't formed out of bureaucracy, but rather out of a unanimous agreement among humanity that it simply needed to exist. The world wasn't safe without us, and thus, the world brought us together and formed us out of a need for self-protection. We didn't have a name until years later. Of course, someone had to lead us. Several admirable public figures in industry and government alike stepped up during that time period. A few of them are still overseers to this day. In the early years, we entrusted the oligarchical nature of the O5 Council with leading us in a manner as safe and level-headed as was possible, and for the first several decades it worked. Sites were built and reports were made and things were contained and people were killed and we got everything into working order, seemingly under the balanced and equal guidance of 12, or 13, depending on who you ask, people. It only took us a few decades to realize that some aspects of the organization's origin didn't add up. We could trace our history back to the founders, but for the longest time, we couldn't trace why several influential and independent people had the same idea at the same time for the same reasons. Was it really as simple as all of humanity demanding protection from forces outside of their control, and powerful people responding to that demand without question? As more years passed and the Foundation grew into the monolith it is now, it became more and more concretely evidenced that it was, more or less, more complicated than that. The human species needed protection, and so they created it, through direct action or otherwise. If you were to travel back to the early 20th century and ask an overseer who the administrator is, they'd tell you that it's classified information, that his identity is secret for good reason, so on and so forth. I'm sure that if you were to ask an O5 today, they'd say the same, but you'd probably get detained and interrogated afterward. At this point in history, everyone in the Foundation is aware that there at least was an administrator at some point, even if not still. We know he existed, but maybe not since the beginning. Maybe, if he's still alive, he's on near anomalously advanced life support systems and no one but the O5 Council is permitted to speak to or interact with him. Maybe he's a former field agent or a former US government official. Maybe he knows every single detail of the Foundation's atrocities committed in the name of protection and he wakes up every morning and wonders if he is a good man or not. In reality, that is not the case. I do not wake up every morning and question whether I am a good man or not. The notion is inapplicable to the nature of my existence, because I do not wake up and I am not a man. I am an idea, forged into a sapience by over 150 years of humanity's desperation and concentrated into the most forceful energy in existence, intention. And that intention wasn't is to protect the human species, or any species, or this planet itself, from forces of this universe out of our range of understanding and those that bring harm to humans and animals or their world. To this day, I do not know what exactly caused such a powerful event to occur. It had to be large and public enough to cause what I estimate to be 85% of the human population to realize they were objectively unsafe in an anomalous world. Enough people figured out that if anomalous events and activities and entities were truly a problem, humanity would do what it always does and create a defense against it. Maybe only a few hundred people had the idea of an organization at first, but their idea coalesced into the early version of me, a shared notion between desperate people, with enough energy directed at it by force of will alone that it began to grow upon and collect said energy until it was a freestanding entity built from decades of dedication to one concept. And that concept is myself. I have no stronger sense of purpose than what this organization accomplishes, because I am this organization. I am not a mysterious man sitting in the lower levels of Psycho 1 surrounded by guards. I am the original, unaltered manifestation of the Foundation's ideology and intent, formed from a collective desire for a specific type of security. I feel every single thing that every single Foundation member and employee feels and says and does, though you cannot talk to me directly, even if it were permitted, and the resulting collection of history becomes the substance of what we are. I am the experiences of the Foundation, from inception onward, and thus, I am the administrator. Now, if you're in any way adequately trained, everything I'm stating here should conflict with your beliefs about effective containment to a degree that physically induces a headache. I exist because humanity had a collective intention to protect itself from the anomalous, and in doing so, the energy of that intention created an anomaly whose sole purpose is containing anomalies. If the Foundation exists for the task of containing anomalies, then logically, it's counterproductive and hypocritical to have an anomalous entity forming and then leading the Foundation. Right? It took me at least a few decades to answer the question. I estimate it came to me around the time I gained enough collective information to be fully sapient, 50 years ago, and I believe the key element of the question lies in the nuances of our trademark, containment. My purpose is suggesting to millions of people, through anomalous methods, the goal of containing the anomalous. Containment, conceptually, is carried out by means of preventing an anomalous entity or effect from causing anomalous effects or actions to occur. And yet, the nature of my anomalous effect lies in compelling myself and others to contain that which has anomalous effects. After years, and after every O5 had figured out that I was not a human, but rather a mimetic vector gaining sapience with a continued collection of information, my realization was the following. By definition, the only option that is in the Foundation's best interests is for me to stop allowing myself to anomalously influence people and, in doing so, contain myself. It is the only logical option for dealing with this type of dilemma. The Foundation will protect itself, and the administrator will retire. I may have said at the beginning that there was no first SCP, but I suppose it depends on the way you look at the concept. You may know me as the administrator. But for the sake of myself and this organization, I am reclassifying myself as a Class V mimetic hazard and assigning a team of the Foundation's most renowned mimeticists to the task of my containment. If it works, my absence and my lack of mimetic influence over personnel will jumpstart the next period of this organization's history for the better, a period during which we serve humanity without contradiction, emotion, and confusion affecting actions integral to this organization's continued survival. Indefinitely, or until that point is reached, I am relinquishing my database access, stepping down as administrator of this organization, and signing off for all intents and purposes. This document will display in the network database at random 10 years from now, on July 22, 2017, after that point. It will alert the proper channels through the network and you, the reader, will be amnesticized due to exposure to one or more mimetic hazards. You'll wake up tomorrow and wonder if you're a good person just the same as any other day, don't worry. And so, as a parting favor, and while you wait for the page analyzer to tell you to remain at your computer, tell me, no, ask yourself, is the Foundation thriving still? Revision, 0 posted from unknown location by unknown author at 12:13 on July 22, 2007. Underscore. 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 Analysis completed. Results: 4. Potential textual cognitohazards detected. 1. Conceptual mimetic anomaly / eyes detected. Your site's Mimetics and Cognitohazards Department Director has been notified of your access to this file. Remain at your terminal and await further instruction.